Last day we talked of topical essays. Topical essays are of those kind which come in single format, just like butterfly. Now we have to write about that. It's a topic and you have to explain, describe and narrate different incidents to stitch the particular topic. Well, descriptive essay consists of description, narrative essay consists of narration. A topical essay is a pure combination of narration as well as description. So we require information and description. Furthermore, we should be careful regarding one thing. Just a reminder of the argumentative essay that you had and that you are going to have. We have mixture of both description and information. What you used to do in argumentative essay, first we describe the topic, then from the next paragraph we explain a real life example, that is a narration. So the format is almost like that. It is not exactly same, almost like that. So while doing that one, while writing this one, you can remember that very topic. Now what you should do and should not do, that we'll discuss graphically in written format. And here you go. Hope this one will be very useful to understand this very topic. Here you go.
It says, so four types of topical essays. First one is exploratory, also called an exploring essay. The exploratory essay allows the writer to examine an idea or experience without backing up a claim or supporting a thesis. This structure is perfect for science essays that explore the characteristics of an organism. So especially the scientific events are being discussed in this very type of essay. Second one is compare and contrast. As the name implies, in a compare and contrast essay, the writer compares and contrasts two different things. English class essays that compare two short stories can be written topic by topic. Topic may be asked, what is better, a mobile phone or a computer? What's better, a mobile phone or a computer? So that's going to be compare and contrast essay. Next is expository. To use an expository essay format, the writer explains something with facts as opposed to using opinion. For example, you should use a topical essay to explain why the South developed an agrarian-based economy before the Civil War. It is regarding America, detailing one characteristics at a time that led to this development. So in this case, what you have to do, you have to explain something with facts. So for your convenience, one topic here I'm providing: why is India and why is India is agrarian economy? So you have to write the essay using facts, logics and valid points. And the last but not the least, the descriptive one. In a descriptive essay, the writer literally describes something. So descriptive essay you are very aware of. So descriptive essay is also a part of topical essay, but here we discard that one. Setting up a topical essay. Once you have chosen or have been assigned an essay topic, the process is as simple as deciding on the correct format. For example, for a compare and contrast essay, you might examine Apple versus Microsoft. One thing for sure, try to be very logical and try to provide a valid proof for your statement. For this kind of essay, you could either describe one subject completely and move on to the next or describe and compare small parts of each subject piece by piece. You can do it point wise. You can write about operating system. You can write about their ecosystem. You can write about their economical development and all these things. So you can do it point wise, piece by piece, or you can write it as a description of full in 3-4 paragraphs. So you have fully describe Apple computers in history, the cost of the products and intended market, for example, then compare those same items for Microsoft Corporation. Or you could compare Star Wars. This is not at all needed. Even you may be asked to compare, if it is in our Indian genre, we can talk about a comparison between private school and government school. Now, other example, for an expository essay, you could explain why you especially enjoy a particular teacher. For your subtopic, you would list the virtuous qualities of the teacher and why you admire this quality. So the question may be asked directly in exam that your favorite teacher, only that much and nothing else. So what you have to do, you have to list the virtuous qualities and of the teacher and why you admire those qualities. You are essentially listening and explaining items, the teacher's features, without backing up your claim, supporting a thesis. That means you don't have any proof or logic for this one. Your subtopics, the teacher's good qualities, are simply your opinions, but you are organizing them into a topical essay format. There is no proof for your statement. So some of the essays will come with proof or logic or statement, and some you don't have to do that. You could use a descriptive format essay. For example, if you were to write about a car company, you would break up the subject by describing its parts. The engineering section, the procurement department, the assembly line. So engineering section, where the cars are designed, procurement department, where the company buys material, assembly line, the cars are actually assembled. You might even break up the assembly line into further subtopics, so you can divide those parts into subparts, such as initial assembly of the body, in order to make your essay easier. Breaking the task into parts, just as you could break down a car into its component parts, make writing an essay extremely easy and joyful. Last but not the least, what we can make one summation of the entire discussion, that topical essays is a fine combination of description and narration. Furthermore, what you are going to have here, it may include logic or may include personal opinion. Personal opinion is not going to be logical all the time. It is your personal choice. So let us follow these simple guidelines to write this essay properly. Just one specimen essay it was given, only the question number was written, and it was written butterfly. So while describing butterfly, you have to be logical with the biological elements it has. But when you describe the aesthetic beauty of butterfly, that is your personal opinion. Or if it is given, what is better, Android or Mac? Or if it is given, what is better, a bus or a train? In that case, you have to be entirely logical while describing your topics. So I wish you will write these things down in your copy and make full use of this one. Thank you.